Well, well, it must be love. We have some pretty exciting news for Honda lovers. Honda has just announced its all-new hydrogen-powered Honda CR-V. As all the CR-V variants are a super hit, Honda is buckling up in the race of EV, keeping performance first. As you're watching Tech Addicts, you'll be the first one among your friends to know what all is going on, so why not start flexing? Before that, let's get into the video to know what is going on. Let's get started. So the executives from Honda recently discussed the ongoing hydrogen business strategies that are being pursued by the OEM. On the same day, it was reported that mass production of the 2023 Honda CR-V Hybrid had commenced in Ohio. During a press briefing on February 2nd, Honda Director and Senior Managing Executive Officer Shinji Aoyama and Business Development Supervisory Unit Head and Operating Executive Arata Ichinose stated that Honda's goal is to work towards carbon neutrality by 2050 through continued product electrification, a proactive approach to increase the use of hydrogen as an energy carrier, and expansion of its hydrogen business. To accomplish the objective, they will need to place a significant amount of emphasis on the development of fuel cell systems in collaboration with General Motors. The goals are to increase the fuel cell system's endurance by 50% and cut its price by one-third. After this goal has been reached, Honda stated that it would continue its investigation into the development of future fuel cell technologies in order to double the durability once more and cut the cost in half at that time. The original equipment manufacturer is interested in incorporating fuel cell technologies into fuel cell cars, commercial vehicles, stationary power plants, and construction machines manufactured by Honda and other companies. It is Honda's intention to begin selling its fuel cell system to customers outside of the company by the middle of the 2020s at a rate of 2,000 units annually, with the number of units sold to increase in stages until it reaches 60,000 units in the year 2030. A few hundred thousand units are expected to be sold annually by Honda by the middle of the second part of the 2030s, according to their plans. Aoyama and Ichinose indicated that the hydrogen circulation cycle begins with renewable energy and consists of three phases: the generation phase, the storage transportation phase, and the usage phase. It is possible to convert the electricity that is derived from renewable energy sources into green hydrogen through the utilization of technology that involves the electrolysis of water. This renders the electricity less susceptible to variations in power generation that are caused by seasonality and the conditions of the weather. Also, it makes it possible for electricity, in the form of environmentally friendly hydrogen, to be transferred via land, sea, and pipelines. According to a press briefing, Honda will expand the applications of its fuel cell system, the core of Honda's hydrogen technology, not only to Honda FC EVs, but also to various internal and external applications, thereby serving to stimulate demand for hydrogen and facilitating the carbon neutrality of society through the use of hydrogen. Since 1983, Honda has been engaged in research and development activities pertaining to hydrogen technologies and fuel cell electric vehicles. Since 2013, Honda's collaborated with General Motors on the development of a fuel cell system for the next generation. The first FC EV, manufactured by Honda and outfitted with the system, is scheduled to go on sale in North America and Japan in the year 2024. The CR-V, which was released in North America just the year before, will serve as the vehicle's inspiration. According to Honda, the production cost of the system will be decreased by one-third in comparison to the 2019 Honda Clarity fuel cell. According to Honda, the cost was reduced by adopting novel materials for electrodes, advancing a cell sealing structure, simplifying the supporting equipment or balance of plant, and improving productivity. With the use of materials that are resistant to corrosion, controlled suppression of deterioration, and low temperature resistance, the product's longevity was increased by a factor of 2. In light of the environmental trends that are occurring around the world, Honda has stated that it will continue expanding the application of its fuel cell systems, which it refers to as the core of Honda's hydrogen technology, beyond its FCEVs, in order to contribute to the realization of a society that is free of carbon emissions. Honda has stated that it views fuel cell systems as key participants in a carbon-neutral society, and that it does not simply want to install them in automobiles. The manufacturer of automobiles is looking for collaborators to test their innovations in commercial vehicles, stationary power plants, and construction gear. According to Hardy, Honda is proactively looking for partners in North America to collaborate with on the development of fuel cell commercial trucks. Honda is already conducting tests of hydrogen power trucks in China with Dongfeng Motors and plans to do the same in Japan with Isuzu before April 2024. Midway through the year 2020, Honda planned to start marketing and selling its fuel cell system to partners in the transportation and industry sectors. Dongfeng Motor Group Company began putting their commercial trucks through the paces in Hubei Province, China, with the purpose of conducting test driving. According to Hardy, basically our message today is really about stating that the fuel cell powertrain is technically ready to step in and help not only Honda, but also other firms to accomplish their carbon neutrality and sustainability goals. In order for those customers to accomplish what they set out to do, we will need to work together to establish the business ecosystem and the hydrogen infrastructure that surrounds that. The application of Honda's fuel cell systems for power generation as a clean and quiet backup power source is something the company intends to offer as well. On the corporate site of the American Honda Motor Company in Torrance, California, a stationary fuel cell power station has been erected. This station will recycle the fuel cell systems from Honda Clarity fuel cell automobiles. It has a capacity of 500 kilowatts, and we will start doing demonstrations of its operation later this month. In the following step, Honda intends to reduce the amount of greenhouse gas emissions that are produced in its operations by implementing technologies that utilize stationary fuel cell power stations at its factories and data centers located all around the world. The car manufacturer has stated that it will provide fuel cell system development and operational support, which will include after-sales maintenance, as well as a consistent supply of hydrogen. This is intended to reduce the amount of money invested in the development process as well as the amount of time required for its implementation. According to Honda, the establishment of hydrogen ecosystems that evolve the supply of hydrogen is a necessary step in the process of achieving widespread adoption of fuel cell systems. They have been helping the growth of hydrogen station networks in North America by providing assistance to firms that operate hydrogen stations. According to the briefing, from this point forward, as a new area, Honda will play an active part in developing hydrogen ecosystems. These ecosystems will be based around stationary power stations and will begin from locations where there is an existing demand for hydrogen. Honda will also be actively participating in programs established by national and local governments that utilize huge volumes of imported hydrogen at ports and other areas. By the implementation of these efforts, Honda intends to strive towards the establishment of relationships with businesses operating within this emerging sector. Employees at Honda's East Liberty Auto Plant had a celebration on February 2nd to mark the beginning of mass production of the 2023 Honda CR-V Hybrid. This event came after the debut of the gasoline-powered CR-V on October 26th in North America of Honda of Canada. The CR-V is equipped with a newly developed two-motor hybrid system that is manufactured at Honda's Ohio transmission plant using domestic and internationally sourced components. Additionally, the CR-V is equipped with a newly refined Atkinson cycle engine that is exclusive to hybrid models produced at the Anna engine plant in Ohio. According to Honda, the 2.0-liter Atkinson cycle four-cylinder engine created at Anna engine plant is the first Honda engine to combine high-pressure direct injection with a multi-stage injection to create a highly uniform mixture that enables clean combustion. The two-motor hybrid electric system incorporates a new arrangement, shifting from coaxial motors of the same size stacked on top of each other to a two-motor parallel axis system with engines of varying sizes mounted side by side. While Honda is true, technology you could enjoy. So how many of you are excited about the hydrogen-powered Honda? Do let us know in the comment section below. And that's all for the video today. We'll be right back. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.